Hello everyone and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco Lesio and welcome back to another video. So guys, today's video we're uncovering Todoist filters. We're going to be giving you a masterclass on how to create Todoist filters, also diving into applying them to my own account. I'm going to be opening up my personal Todoist account and making a few Todoist filters, as well as sharing the ones I've already created. And then we're gonna leave you with a few recommended resources to dive into. So run the introduction. So guys, in today's video, we are diving into Todoist filters as mentioned. This week is a full week of Todoist and Twist. They are run obviously by a company called Doist. Doist have kindly sponsored this full week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So it's good to have some exclusive videos all about Todoist and Twist and how to advance your use of them. So be prepared this week, it's gonna be quite an exciting week for that. I have been a long time user of Todoist, so filters have been an area where it's taken me a lot of time to dive into. I've only created some really basic ones at the moment, but what I wanted to do in this video is create a few for myself, demonstrate on how to use them, and also uncover some of the more advanced setups that you could have. This is going to be a useful tutorial for you to really get started with your filters. So guys, I'm really excited for today's video. Let's jump over to the laptop and dive into Todoist filters. First, I want to show you some of the filters that I create, and also I'm going to show them up on the screen, what queries I have with them, so that I can give you an outline of the ones that I use in my daily routine. I'm then going to be diving into how to create a filter from scratch, as well as all of the query elements that you may need to get started. So here are a few filters in my situation. This might give you some basic outline of what I go for when I'm using filters. So filters down here for me reside in these three areas. The first one is called plan highlight, and that's really simply a way for me to plan in my most important task across the week. So if I click plan highlight, I can see the upcoming most important tasks that I have for the next 3 days. I try to only have one highlight per day. This is actually from a book called Make Time, which I stole the idea and applied it to Todoist. And it's actually become a very helpful way of being a bit more cleaner in my approach to my tasks. Once I complete my highlight, I feel much more productive to a lot of extents. So the next one I do have is Schedule Week. Schedule Week allows me, at the end of, as I mentioned in my Notion Plus Todoist feature that I did, on Thursday PM afternoon, I tend to sit down and review my full week. What I do is I get this one out and plan the week next so that I have a full outline of what I have here. And that's just very simply a query for next week, which I'll demonstrate. And finally, a low priority folder that allows me to complete emails, mainly the ones that I tag in that low priority folder with the P3 are all email based. So that helps me there. So you're probably wondering, what are the queries behind that? If I click edit filter, that's 10 days, so the next 10 days, and at highlight, anything with at highlight in it as a label, very simple. And we'll talk about through this in a minute and when we dive into the filters area. If I hit edit here, it's the next 10 days for my schedule week. I don't even have to click the next, I just have 10 days. And emails to send are in the project tasks with P3 as a priority. So that's how I mainly set up the three filters that I have right now. Let's dive into how to create filters. So let's give you a little outline of how you can create a filter. All you have to do is open up this filters tab on this left-hand panel and hit add filter. Now let's decide we want to choose anything that's priority one for today, or actually let's say tomorrow. So P1 for tomorrow, let's say is the title, so that we can be a bit clear, and we'll add a red icon so you can give a color to any of the filters you have. For creating the query, all you have to do is press P1, which is priority one. If you wanted priority two or three, for example, you'd put P2, but in this case, we're having P1, and we're gonna put and tomorrow as the due date. So you can add pretty much anything to your query. You can add, and the most popular ones are due dates, priority, projects, and labels. You can add a project really easily. So for example, if I wanted to choose only ones from my tasks inbox that I have, then I'd use hashtag tasks to be able to organize that. If I had a project within that project, all I'd have to do is add another hashtag and find that name there if it was underneath another one. So that's if you've got any sub projects going. Now, if I wanted to, I can add a due date to. If I wanted to add the next 5 days, for example, that could be the one that you select there. You could also have a due before. So, for example, if I wanted to put due before, let's say, the 20th of October instead of this tomorrow due date, then I could do that quite easily. And as you can see here, any priority one task due before the 20th of October, in this case, that's already gone. But if I put 30th, for example, it would come up all inside of this one. Now, you can also put assigned to if you want to, as a way to indicate if tasks are given to other people. And you can also have, and you can create your own symbols. So for example, in this demonstration, we put and literally means and as a symbol. But if you wanted to put or, you can do this very simply and put a, it's almost like a line. I don't actually know the technical term for it, but I'll add it below. And if you want to include not anything that does not include anything, it's gonna be an exclamation mark. So for example, let's say I change this one, anything due before the 30th of October. Let's say I've got a holiday coming up, and that's going to be one of the demonstrations we'll do later. We'll call it P130. As you can see here, all of those priority ones due before the 30th of October are created there. Now, if I wanted to create two lists inside this, it would be really simple if I clicked edit and I put a comma between it. That's creating two lists, essentially. So if I wanted it my own view with these two different areas or filters running, let's say I wanted that P1 for tomorrow or P2 for tomorrow, then all I had to do is hit save. And as you can see here, a separate one is created just below it. So commas do help to break it out, and you can have multiple of those going on, which is quite helpful. So that's a really basic way of setting up your own filters. Now let's put this into practice with my own setup. I've got three or four filters that I want to create here. I'm going to put the queries on the screen for you to go away and maybe apply. So what I need to do and what I want to do is I want to create a priority one for today in case I have any really important tasks that need to get done during the day. So priority today, and give it a bit of a big red one here. And that would just be simply P1 and today. You could put Todd if you want to. And if I hit add filter, you'll see I actually don't have any priorities today. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag this to the top because I'm gonna prioritize it in this filters box. Now, I also have an idea that, for example, I've got a little vacation due, a trip to Bath, let's say, but you could apply this to any holiday you want. And for example, you could say any tasks that I created at a P1 and are due before the 26th of October. And if I click add, you'll see all of those tasks appear. These are the ones pretty much during the week that I need to complete. This is useful because, for example, if you're heading for a vacation, which I am, and I don't want any work on this weekend, then these are the major tasks I actually need to complete before I go away. So that's quite a helpful one if you're very vacation orientated and you want to really get away. Now, if I want to, I can actually see the tasks that I created yesterday, and that's something I do want to start seeing. So I'm going to put tasks yesterday. I'm going to give it a nice lavender. If I click add filter, you can actually see the tasks that I created yesterday. I only added the additional shopping list to yesterday's item. So it gives you a good idea of the tasks that you've already implemented from the day before. Now, I need a task with actually anything below 30 minutes that I can do during the week. So for example, let's say I want to put 30 minutes or less as the task title. I'll give it a nice like brownie look. And then if I add 5 minutes, because these are all the 5 minute tasks, and I put or at 10 minutes or at 20 minutes, these are all the tasks and labels that I have that are below that. So that's what's going to appear because I only have one that has a 5 minute label right now. So that's a helpful one if I need to do that. So on this left-hand panel, I've almost got a rainbow of filters that I can get started with. A priority today, a trip to Bath, and that can be related to any holiday. One that I can see all of my most important tasks for the week, a schedule of my full week, emails that I need to send, tasks that I completed or created yesterday, and anything that will take 30 minutes or less. And I can start applying this label to more of them, and of course, it will start populating that, which is very helpful. Now, what I recommend to go away from this video and check out is the Mike Vardy video we did. Mike Vardy combines his day themes with his labels and day views. He has a really advanced methodology around filters that I definitely recommend checking out. So I recommend checking out Dandy with Lens. He has an ultimate guide to Todoist filters, which is a perfect outline. So it's definitely worth checking out. Now, the one thing that I would add to this is if you get a filter that you truly, truly enjoy, let's say I'm starting to use this one a lot more, you can hit the add to favorites and that can pin quite nicely at the top. Anyway, guys, hopefully you found some value in this feature today. So feel free to pop some Todoist filter questions below and I'll happily answer them or recommend a few resources that you can go away into detail. Again, it's something that I need to dive into more, but this is a really basic outline of the Todoist filters function. If you are not subscribed yet, hit the subscription button. And a big thank you to Todoist for sponsoring this week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Thank you very much, guys, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers.